Hello, today's video is on stock number 32575MD. We're making a video of it today because we've been having a lot of people asking for a mechanical drawing of the part, and it simply isn't available because it is a surplus part. So this video is here to give you a good visual on how it looks, where the, you know, all the different angles and such. Like most surplus parts, it does have a story behind it. It is believed to be a GM seat positioner, would move probably a lumbar support because it is relatively short. But from what we can tell, this is just an unsubstantiated rumor, but it seems to fit the bill for it. Like most of these type things, it has a nice little pivot point on the back. So you got two different. I have a quarter inch dowel, as you see, so it makes it nice so it as it can move freely in one position. We call it a right hand motor just because we're used to the right angle, but it could be the manufacturer considered left angle, right angle, left angle. We don't know, so please don't buy it thinking this is going to work for your car. There's many different threads. There's different we can't guarantee it to work for the intended purpose. Next thing is the connector, the power. It's all done through this little housing. Get an angle here, you can see it like that. Like in most automotive, it's just designed for a big locking connector. You can either, like some people, just cut this off, or deep inside there's two 0.187 male quick connect terminals. You can simply use fully insulated just to keep from shorting out, or you can solder to it if you got nimble fingers and get in there to it. But that is kind of a drawback on the part, is the connector. Okay, well, when we first bought these, they didn't have a nut, so we ended up having to go to a manufacturer and having these made just because it make the part more useful. We don't like to sell them separately, just because there's many different threads and we've had too much bad experience of people getting them and say it doesn't fit mine. Well, we can't guarantee it to fit yours. We just had these made for this. We actually took the shaft to the machine shop and they were able to make the part for us. So we sell with that. On there, the hole nut itself is 1 3/8 in diameter. It's about 11/16 of an inch in thickness. And the faceplate of the travel nut is about 3/16 of an inch thick. Okay, that's that part. Now let's get to the spec. 12 volts DC. Leadscrew motor is reversible. It is reversible. At 6 volts DC, it runs at 88 RPMs. At 12 volts DC, it's at 178 RPMs. And I see somebody tried it at 24 volt DC, and it was about 380 RPMs. Like I said, these are just our best guess estimates running and playing with the part. No factory spec. This is all just best guess. No load at 12 volts DC. It is 1.5 amp. Actually has about a 17 amp stall current, so that's pretty stout, pretty hard here. Best thing I could do, that's the part as we would ship it to you with the nut, get the motor as is, maybe wrap a little bubble wrap, hopefully. Now, but what we've done for our store is we've made this nice little store demo. It's just mounted on an aluminum plate, toggle switch, a little power supply. It's just simply running off of a 12 volt, 2.5 amp supply. This will see it is reversible. Give you an idea how fast it travels up and down. And I can even come in here and really kind of put some weight behind it. And you can see it barely slows the motor down at all. All right, that is our video for this part. Thank you for watching.